people, welcome. Are we live?
It's not showing up.
Not showing up?
It is for me.
Oh, it is? Okay.
Are we live?
Yeah.
All right, guys, sorry about the wait. This is our last one for the year. I don't know how many it is. Probably we're talking in the 30s now, and I've done over 40 since the start of COVID. COVID started over here in the Bay Area on the 15th of March. And I started doing live streams the Sunday after that, originally for 7 Mile House, because we had a lot of musicians working there. We wanted to try and get the focus back on what musicians are doing. So along the way, I hooked up with the great bassist here, Jeff Saxton, and we started doing the stuff in his backyard. So we used to do Live at 5 in Jeff's backyard. That was the first jazz club. So I went from solo saxophone or playing along with Bill Evans, McCoy Tyner, Wynton Kelly, people like that, to playing with a band of all-star local heroes and some imports too. So that's been how it's been going here since, I guess that's what, April?
June 7th was the first one.
June 7th was the first one of the house. Okay, so that gives you an idea of what we've been doing in the short and long of it. We're going to keep doing it because we're back on lockdown again, but we feel it's our responsibility to bring you some great jazz, and that's what we aim to do. So with that being said, let me introduce the wonderful guys in the band, and then I'll talk in between the few numbers. Today's going to be a retrospective. We lost a lot of great musicians this year to COVID and to other things, but COVID took a huge toll on jazz, as it did on just about everything else. So anyway, today, the all-star band, we have our regular house trumpet player, and it's in the house because it's in my living room. I'm Modesto Brezzani on the trumpet. As I said, our double bassist was the club owner before I decided to go bankrupt and do it in my house, and that is Jeff Saxton on the double bass. We're lucky to have all the way from New York, but she's been hanging out in COVID times here in the Bay Area, along with her great friend Essiet Essiet, who is probably somewhere in the wings. How about a round of applause for Sylvia Cuenca? And today, by special appointment, we have another one of the fine piano players from the Bay Area, but he's been heard all around the world too. His name is Joe Warner. We'd like to invite him to our aggregation. We're going to start with a composition. We always try and warm up with something, so that's what we're going to do with this. It's called Gingerbread Boy by Jimmy Heath. Let me just get some music organized here for a second. So I know where I'm at. Start with the band.
Oh,
So that was a composition by Jimmy Heath. We're going to play another one of his later. But we're going to launch straight into another tune. One of our great supporters this summer has been a great friend and a mentor of mine. He's really one of our greatest saxophone players ever. His name is Charles McPherson, and we've played a few of his compositions off his latest album called Jazz Dance Suites. I think it's one of the great albums for this year, but it's got a great theme to it, and I think it's going to be a timeless album. So we're doing a shout out to Charles McPherson. We're actually going to play one of his other compositions today. This is called Manhattan Nocturne. Hope you enjoy this by Charles McPherson.
Thank you.
an upturn. All right. So, this is the album, people. It's called Jazz Dance Suites by Charles McPherson. Check it out. A big shout out goes to him and his wonderful family in sunny San Diego. And all that he brings us, the joy he brings us with his incredible musicianship, and the whole family for that matter, great. So, Jazz Dance Suites, Charles McPherson. So, this year, as I was saying earlier, we lost quite a lot of some very important jazz players. And we lost two guys who were on the same record with me a few years ago. Branford Marsalis, great friend of mine, he produced a really fantastic record featuring the drummer Jimmy Cobb. It's called Marsalis Music Presents Jimmy Cobb, a quartet album. And on the piano was Branford's father, Ellis, wonderful, wonderful piano player, but also really an amazing educator and mentor to many students and to many musicians. And that's what this art is really about. It's about mentoring and passing on the tradition. It's a very young art in a lot of ways as far as world history goes. So jazz is one of these beautiful things where you can chart that through. Ellis is one of these figures who has passed his knowledge on to so many people after some great experiences with other people. So we miss him terribly. We're going to play one of his compositions actually off that recording now. And we're going to play another one later of Jimmy Cobb's compositions. This one, I think, was written by Ellis for this album, but I'm sure I'll be corrected if I'm wrong by one of the family members. But a shout out goes to all the Marsali. We love them all dearly. And this tune is called Tell Me by Ellis Marsalis, the great Ellis Marsalis.
Oh,
I said, one of the great mentors, one of the great piano players, and obviously a wonderful father to an incredible family of musicians. They are part of his legacy, but there are so many other great musicians that are part of his legacy in jazz. And we're going to play another one by the guy we started with, that's Jimmy Heath, because he is another very, very, very important person when it comes to the legacy of young jazz musicians. He was mentored by the great Dizzy Gillespie, and anyone who knows anything about John Coltrane knows that they were very close, and in some ways he was one of these real pathfinders of a lot of the stuff that John Coltrane was doing in the early 1950s. So he had that legacy going on. He was called Little Bird before that because he sounded so much like Charlie Parker. And I remember I met him when I was 16 years old in Sydney, Australia. He always used to tell a lot of stories about me driving him around because I just got my license at that stage. So it was pretty hair-raising, but he also taught me some of the most important things, some of the things that I use to this day and that I've taught everybody that I've taught, like original important things that Dizzy Gillespie taught him and that Charlie Parker passed to him. He did that to everybody. So anybody I'm talking to who knows this music and knows Jimmy Heath knows exactly what I'm talking about. We played a tune of his, the first tune, which is called Gingerbread Boy. When he came out to Australia with the Philip Morris Superband, he'd just written another tune. Not only did he give me a lesson with the great James Moody in the house, both of them teaching somebody who could hardly play at that stage a whole lot of music. But then he said, so here's a new tune. I'm about to record it, and it's got a lot of interesting stuff in it. It'll probably keep you working for a while. And so this is the tune we're going to play. It's called New Picture by Jimmy Heath, the great Jimmy Heath. We lost him earlier in the year. Big shout out goes to Mona and Tootie and all the Heath clan, and also all of his great bandmates, and of course everybody who has been in contact with Jimmy Heath, because another great, very important mentor in jazz. So this is New Picture by Jimmy Heath. Just keep on back on that first chord. One, two, three, two, three, four. New picture, Jimmy Heath. May he rest in power, as we say. Jimmy Heath, very, very, very important musician to so many other musicians. There's a great book by him, and it's called Walking Amongst Giants. Anyone who knows Jimmy knows he was about 5'2" on high heels, but his sound was huge. His command of the saxophone was incredible, and his understanding of the music of jazz is one thing, but his understanding of music in general was beyond belief. And he had curiosity forever, for days and days. And there's something about all these great jazz artists like Ellis and Jimmy. So very, very sad year for us this year. Another one we lost was on that first album I was talking about that Bramford produced, featuring Jimmy Cobb. So we're going to play a tune off that album. Ellis played on that album too. This is a tune written by Jimmy Cobb. And the interesting thing about this is I was involved in the preparation for the record, so I wasn't sure what was going to happen when we featured Jimmy. So I prepared a lot of music, and I knew Ellis would come with something so that we could make the album work. I got there and saw Jimmy. I'd known Jimmy for a lot of years because I played with him with Nat Adderley years and years before, and hugely important to everything. Really one of the great drummers in the history of this music. And there's a lot of great drummers, but he's right up there with anyone. His contribution is amazing. But he came prepared. He came with some original compositions, some beautiful ones. And this next one we're going to play is the ballad that he wrote for the album. It's called Eleanor for his sister. He wrote it for his sister. It's a very pretty tune. And last week I played a tribute because we lost Jeff Clayton, a wonderful saxophone player from the Los Angeles area, but his acclaim is worldwide too. So when I'm playing this melody, I'm thinking of Jeff because he would have loved this tune. When I was thinking about it, I thought about all the great players who played the alto saxophone. So it's one of those beautiful melodies. It's called Eleanor. Eleanor by Jimmy Cobb. I hope you enjoy it.
Oh,
so much with Jimmy Cobb. I owe a real understanding of rhythm to him, because I also watched him teach a lot. And he was a man of actually very few words, but everything he said had a very deep meaning. And of course, he'd been around all of the Cats, so I stored all that information away, and some of it is on video, and some of it is on tape, and some of it is written down. So I'm happy to pass that out to cats who want it. Which brings me to my next subject. Last week we were lucky enough to have a guest along play with us. His name is John Gordon. He's a wonderful, wonderful saxophone player from New York. He's hanging out in the Bay Area. But I want to give his book a plug. It's called Jazz Dialogues. And the reason I want to give it a plug is because it's kind of what I'm talking about lineage, about mentoring, teaching, all of those things. John has done a great service by documenting some of his interactions. He's a musician about my age, and we came up with a lot of influence by other musicians, as we all did. Sylvia has lots of stories. Mo has lots of stories. Jeff, Joe, we all have stories about other cats. But a lot of the stories contain great information about how this music works, how we're supposed to pass it on, all those things. So this is another one of those great books. Check it out, John Gordon, Jazz Dialogues. And it talks to a lot of the people we're talking about today. Jimmy Cobb, we lost him this year. Jimmy Heath, Ellis Marsalis, a lot of guys. The next guy, we're going to play a piece. It's not by him. It's by great jazz trumpet player Clifford Brown. And he chose to play this tune quite a lot because he was a great jazz trumpet player, one of the greats. And he passed away with COVID very early on. We lost him. He was really the protege of Miles Davis. Miles Davis kind of really took him under his wing. But he was already a fine player even before that happened, because he'd gone through all of those great things too. So his name is Wallace Roney. I got to play with him a couple of times just in jam session settings. Some of the other members of the band have had much more personal experiences playing with him, and he did a lot, especially when there were a whole lot of young lions on the scene coming about in the early 1980s. And these were the cats with the real information, playing the what I call the right stuff. And so Wallace Roney, we're going to pay a little tribute to Wallace Roney now on the next tune. We're going to play a Clifford Brown composition called Da Hood. Hope you enjoy this. Is it clipping or what's it doing?
I don't know yet. Just call her.
Okay. If it's clipping, we'll put out another copy later, because we're doing this in dual. So. That's anything? So we need 4 bar counting, because I got to play a pickup. 1, 2, 1, 2.
Oh,
Ronning, Dahoud, great Wallace Ronning. How about a round of applause for our wonderful band here? This is Modesto Brezenia on the trumpet, Joe Warner on the piano, Sylvia Cuenca on the drum, and our benefactor in a lot of ways and co-host on all of this stuff, Mr. Jeff Saxton on the double bass. Yours truly, Andrew Spade on the saxophone. This is our retrospective for 2020, COVID country. So we'd actually like to invite to the stage a friend to play a couple more tunes. We've got a couple more tribute tunes of people that we lost this year that were very important musicians in the history of music. So his name is Essiet, wonderful bass player. So he's going to play some bass for us. Thank again Jeff Saxton for all of his wonderful stewardship with our proceedings here. And I know he's going to get a nice drink now. That's what we do here, you know. That's the part of living room jazz is fun. We're going to play a tune now. This is we lost a wonderful alto saxophone player, composer, stylist, important stylist in jazz this year. And I got to meet him a number of times because when he'd come to San Francisco, he would call me up and borrow my horn. He never traveled with his horn. He would call somebody up. So I remember when he first came out here, like in 2000, 2001 or something, he calls me and says he's coming to town and could I borrow a saxophone? So I came up to his hotel room with three saxophones and he chose the one he wanted, and that's a long story for saxophone players. Got a lot of information just from that. But he did it many times. He always wanted the same saxophone after he played that. It's not the one I'm playing today because the one that he played had a totally different sound and texture and everything else. But his name is Lee Konitz, and Lee Konitz was one of these fantastic saxophone players. When he came up in the late 1940s, he was said to have the only style that was really different to Charlie Parker on an instrument, and it was vastly different, and he influenced a heck of a lot of other musicians, and he had lots of great stories, and he passed a lot of information on to a lot of cats, and so this is a tribute to him. Why I'm playing this tune is because actually, the first time when we did that, we played, when I handed off my horn to him, he wanted to play a tune in the hotel room, and he picked this tune. It's a Cole Porter tune. It's called You'd Be So Nice to Come Home To. Hope you enjoy this. Lee Konitz loved this tune. He loved a lot of great standard tunes.
Oh,
2020 without too many scars. 2021 is going to be great on all accounts, I believe. A new day for us all. So thank you very much for being a part of our COVID concert series. We'll keep doing this. We're going to play one more tune by, again, somebody we lost this year. We lost him early in the year, and his contribution was huge. He kind of changed the way a lot of people played piano in jazz, and you can pretty much hear the echoes of his influence on any young jazz player today. He's best known for his work in the John Coltrane Quartet, but his roots were, along with Jimmy Heath, from one of the great cities in jazz, and he was already a legend down there before he got with John Coltrane. He played with Art Farmer and Benny Golson, a number of people. So he had well developed his style, but when he got with John Coltrane, they changed the musical landscape for us all. His name is McCoy Tyner, and we're going to play one of his tunes. It's off a great album, one of my favorite albums in jazz. It's called The Real McCoy, and this is a tune called Passion Dance. Thanks for tuning in. Again, Modesto Brezania, Joe Warner, Essiet Essiet playing the double bass, Sylvia Cuenca, Jeff Saxton over here. And all of the other people who have helped us, like Keith Saunders. Last week we had Javier San Diego. We've got a lot of great players that have passed in along the way. John Gordon, as I said. We'd like to thank all those people who participated in 2020. 2021 is going to be great for us. Yours truly, Andrew Spade on saxophone. This is McCoy Tyne and Passion Dance. Thank you very much. Notes, as they said about Mozart, too many notes. One, two, one, two, one, two. Thank you.
Thank you.
To all those great musicians we lost this year, we thank you very much. Thank you so much. And that was for all the bebop lovers out there. Thank you, and good night.